and welcome to the Parts Table Overview tutorial. Here we'll cover what a part is and the different ways that we can describe them in Arctos. After we're done here, I suggest checking out the tutorial on how to add, edit, and delete parts to see this all in action. So, you can view a specimen's parts on its record webpage. Here we have a northern goshawk as an example. The parts table is over on the right side of the screen, and here we can see that this record has both a feather and a skull. This parts table displays information for each of the specimen parts in a table, with each part having its own row. The information that's displayed for each part includes things like the part name, condition, disposition, whether it's on loan or not. We'll dive into these in a minute. First, let's talk about what a part is. So one specimen record can have one or more parts to it, all associated with the same catalog number. This is often the case if your specimen preparation process creates multiple products. In this example, the goshawk was prepped into being both a skull and a feather. So why does this feature even exist on Arctos? Well, separating out each part like this allows you to track loan status, storage location, conditions, remarks, etc. for each of the parts independently, since each of the parts will likely be used and managed in different ways and at different times. It allows someone to search your collection for specific part types, as well as assist you with managing your collection. So let's take a look at this in more detail. To do that, we'll open up the parts window by clicking the Edit link in the upper right corner of the table. So here we see the existing parts lined up along the top. This blue box is where we can add parts, but that'll be in another tutorial. Let's start with the left-hand column, which would be part name. So the part name is the label for what the part is, and perhaps some information about how it's stored or how it was prepped. It is controlled vocabulary in Arctos, so if you type something in and hit tab, a window will pop up with options for that keyword. For example, let's just type in part of the word feather, and we can get our feather results. But let's take a look at all of the options that are available for a part name. To do that, we'll click Define Values to get the full list. And here we go. As you can see, there's quite a few things to choose from. And a lot of these are pretty specific and other ones are more general. So for example, we have both simply tail, but we also have tail tip frozen. And it's up to you to make the call about how specific you want to be in your part names. Consider how a researcher might be searching for certain parts in your collection. Would they be more likely to search for skeleton or for left femur? You do have the option of keeping that part name more general and then adding more details in the remarks field. For example, this skull is just labeled as skull, but then we have a remark here to include more information of includes mandible, cervical vertebrae. This is kind of a happy medium between the two. Next, we have disposition. This is whether it's in collection, missing, on exhibit, unknown, used up, etc. And you can select that by those are the options that are on the drop-down menu. Next, we have condition. This is where you can record any notable abnormalities about the part, specifically like any damage. Any changes you make here are going to be logged by Arctos. So we can view that by just clicking this history link. And we would see all the different entries that this condition has been changed in the past, along with the date it was changed and who changed it. Now, you can always view this, or you can have a practice to include the date and determiner in the field itself of the condition, just so you can see it right away if you want to use that as a best practice. Next, we have this pound sign, number sign, as count or quantity. This is where you can designate the size of the group of that type of part. This is true also if you have a lot of specimens. And if you're unsure about the exact number of that lot, you could put an estimate here and then describe how you got that estimate in the remark field. Next, we have barcodes and containers. This would be how you assign the part to a storage container if you use barcode identifier system. Again, this is for containers and not necessarily for general storage locations. The location can be added as an additional attribute, but that'll be covered in the how to add, edit, and delete parts tutorial. Next, we have the remarks, which is where you can put any other information about the part, such as specific contents, like this example here, or possibly when it was last inventoried. It's kind of a catch-all bin for anything else you want to add. So this concludes the Parts Table Overview tutorial. Be sure to check out the How to Add, Edit, and Delete Parts tutorial to see this all in action. And you can also find a suite of other tutorials that are related to specimen parts available through Arctos. Thank you for watching.